It's Monday, March 14th. I'm Natalie Morris, and it's time to get loaded. Google has compiled a collection of high-resolution before and after satellite images of Japan that depict the areas most affected by the recent devastation. Google hopes that this will better illustrate the magnitude of the event and motivate us all to help in some form or fashion. Also, AT&T is allowing customers to call or text to Japan for free until the end of March. This is for customers in the U.S. and Puerto Rico to communicate with Japanese friends and family. And the rest of us can, of course, text Red Cross to 90999 in order to make a $10 donation to the Red Cross relief effort. In other Google news, the company may be ready to take yet another attempt at building a social network. Rumors of a new Google social network circulated this weekend. Google has denied that it will launch this week, but not that the project exists. The code name is Circles. It focuses on your smaller networks of friends and family in a more private form of social networking, as opposed to just putting your whole life on Facebook for all the world to see. Due to power limitations in Japan, Sony is temporarily shutting down the servers for its massive multiplayer online role-playing games, such as Final Fantasy and Play Online games and services. The games will be back, but Sony is trying to comply with the power company's request to conserve, so they're going offline temporarily. There is no indication of how long this blackout will last, but your account will not be billed while the servers are down. Netflix is not interested in selling you movies, only renting them to you. Movie studio execs have been grumbling that they have asked Netflix to sell movies, and the movie rental company has said, not interested. The request involved adding a buy button next to the rental options, but for now, this is a non-starter. A new wireless spectrum is being hotly contested by GPS manufacturers. A company called LightSquared is planning to build a wireless broadband system via satellite on the L-band frequency, which is adjacent to the frequency used by GPS. GPS companies are saying this is too close and it threatens GPS usefulness by potentially jamming the frequencies. Companies have banded together to form SaveOurGPS.org. The FCC has issued a conditional waiver allowing LightSquared's network to get started, and these companies want to prevent that from happening, or at the very least, they want the public to have a 45-day comment period on the matter, and they want the FCC to conduct conclusive research on this network. And of course, the iPad 2 sold like gangbusters this weekend. In fact, the device sold out in most stores and back-ordered on the internet. Analysts predict that 70% of iPad 2 buyers are new iPad owners. Preliminary estimates are that nearly 1 million units were sold in just 3 days. And finally, here's an app that I think Apple will probably pull from the iTunes App Store soon, the Sexy Time Soundtrack app. It uses the iPhone's accelerometer to crack jokes while you're making love to someone else, or to yourself, I suppose. It uses the phone's accelerometer to measure your movement. The app costs $1 in the App Store, and please do not send us reports of how it works. None of us here have tested it. It will not be featured on Tap That App. That's your news of the day. Remember CNET.com/loaded for links to all the stories we've discussed. I'm Natalie Morris for CNET, and you've just been loaded.